I've had quite a few people ask me about the weave and cast on and the problems they've had, and I still do this to today. I just forget to set up the carriage the wrong way. This is for the Singer Studio, Silver Reed Machines, Knit Master. Toyota and Elma has a bulky that's the same as the 155. Pretty much when you got the side levers here and the Russell levers, the Russell levers don't really are not part of it, but the side levers and the tuck brushes. So now the manual tells you, I believe, to bring the needles out to working position. I always bring them out to hold. And I forget if it's the actual first one or the second needle from the end opposite the carriage. But you're going to take and put those, every other needle, back to work position, and then you're going to put the yarn. Now you want to make sure those hooks are behind the back edge here. You're going to put the yarn over the needles here and hold. And normally what you're going to do is bring the side levers forward, tuck brushes down, but just to show you, if you forget to do that, this is what happens. Now, the bottom yarn here did catch on a couple of them. My biggest thing is I always forget the tuck brushes. So now let me go with the second needle from the end. Again, laying the yarn over the open hooks. This time, I'm going to put just the side levers forward to show you what happens there. And again, I get a long thread here. This is not the way it's supposed to cast on. That's where the tuck brushes come in handy for this cast on. So again, let me try with the last needle. And this time I'm going to put my tuck brushes down. Now I have that weave and cast on. Let me zoom in on this so you could see what it's supposed to look like. And there you go. That's the way the weave and cast on should look like. Now the manual does say that you could go ahead and continue knitting. There's been times I've had a problem with this, but I want to point out that the end needle here is just looped over, so I think I was supposed to start with the second needle in. But what I would do is, if I have a cast-on comb, I could go onto the loops that is actually, if I was to pull the yarn tail here, it would cinch it up. But what I want to do is I want to take that yarn, go into the carriage, and put it under a hook there. Now I could go ahead, put my side levers back and my tuck brushes up, and continue knitting. And of course, this is more for waist yarn. I would like to get the carriage on the left so I could do a row of ravel cord to get the carriage on the right, unless the pattern stipulates to start it on the left. Now, these machines do not come with a cast-on comb. This is from my LK100. And you only have the claw weights. So you would, after a couple rows, hang a claw weight on each end of the material. Then put your tuck brushes up and your side levers back and continue knitting. Now, if you're going to start out with live stitches, that's fine. You would just, after the ravel cord, you would just go ahead and continue knitting with the main yarn. But if you're doing this waist yarn and a row of ravel cord and you want live stitches, this is where you would end up with the carriage on the right. Push the needles forward and push the material back behind the open latches. Take your main yarn and E-wrap, latch toe wrap, whatever, the first row, cast on the same needles and just go for it.